November 4th, 2007.
In the NFL, concussions are under great medical scrutiny. But in U.S. high schools...
I want you to say the months of the year backwards to me.
Athletic concussions are a growing public health concern.
6 years ago, Max Conradt played quarterback and defensive end for Waldport High School in Oregon. After taking several hard hits during this game, a doctor said he suffered a concussion, but Max played the next Friday night.
Back to throw, here comes the blitz, and he's gonna get mauled over.
Max took several more hits in that game, and then, at halftime, he collapsed unconscious on the sidelines. He spent the next 2 months in a coma. In Max's case, his brain was severely damaged, and his life forever altered.
What happened?
What happened?
Yeah.
You were hurt in a football game.
What?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Teenagers often compete without proper medical supervision.
Max's father, Ralph, says that his son's high school did not have a sufficient medical staff.
There was no certified athletic trainer at the game. There was no doctor at the game.
There are probably only 23% of the schools in the United States, high schools in the United States, that have athletic trainers.
Obviously, the goal would be to have a certified athletic trainer at every high school, but for financial reasons that, you know, isn't realistic. And so right now, because of that, and because of liability involved, it falls on the coaches.
Is the question, did I check on him?
Yeah.
Yes, I did.
Okay, how did you check on him?
How are you feeling?
Tell me if you need a break. Yes? Okay.
They're very busy individuals that pour their heart and soul into coaching, but they're not medical professionals.
He said he'd had a headache over the weekend. His mom, he was up all night. He had some headache pills.
If the kid had symptoms of a concussion, he should not have gone in, period.
Medical professionals gotten together and let us know that he's waiting a week. He's asymptomatic before he goes in.
You return to play prior to becoming symptom free for a period of time, you are at a high risk for a syndrome where suddenly lack of control of blood flow to the brain develops, the brain floods, the pressure becomes massive, and death or major morbidity occurs.
I had my brain injury, and, well, I want to go on with my life.
And although he says he dreams of being a writer, it isn't easy for Max to use his computer.
If you had any advice for high school football players, what would it be?
Check the date of the helmet. My helmet was 20 years old.
Chipped up by Conradt, took it in the head too, as he got run over by Warren.
I felt really betrayed when I found out that he had a 20-year-old helmet.
Max's helmet was made in 1981 and then later reconditioned. He filed a lawsuit against the company that did the reconditioning, and it was settled out of court.
Medical experts do say that even reconditioned older helmets can increase the risk of concussions.
Blink for me if Katie's in the room. She's in the room, yeah.
I want to do everything that I planned on doing.